Hi students, welcome to chemistry online classes. The last class I discussed about some physical properties of carboxylic acid. I think that is a boiling point. Now we will discuss about the solubility of carboxylic acids. The well-known solubility means any one of the organic compound soluble in water, it depends upon its polar nature and its hybrid bond formation with water. So we know carboxylic acid RC double bond OH. This is carboxylic acid, and we know that water molecule. So when carboxylic acid added to the water, it is soluble. When up to this carbons, according to our textbook, it is given carbon number C1 to C4 carboxylic acids are soluble. In some books also may be given up to 5 carbon. All organic compounds up to 5 carbons are easily soluble in the water, but follow our textbook, up to C4 carbon. 1 carbon mean formic acid, C4 carbon mean what you call butanoic acid. Formic acid, ethanoic acid, propanoic acid, butanoic acid. These are soluble in water. How these are soluble in water? Because of reason is, one is polar nature, second one is hydrogen bond. Polar compounds are soluble in the polar solvent. Like this statement you studied in the first year in chemical bonding, light dissolves light. Polar soluble in polar, non-polar soluble in the non-polar. So these are polar and forming the hydrogen bond with water, not itself you hydrogen bond that is applicable for boiling point. So hydrogen bond formed with the water molecule, that is applicable for solubility. So how it form the hydrogen bond, we see here. This is a water molecule, then observe here, this more electronegative, this less electronegative. More electronegative will get the negative charge, less electronegative get the positive charge. This indicating partial negative, this is partial positive. Then here this is also partial positive, then it is what is that? Partial negative. Then we have here carboxylic acid, this is negative charge, it forms hydrogen bond. So in between this negative and this positive charge, we have the hydrogen bond. Similarly here HO, C double bond O R. So in between also we have the hydrogen bond, because this partial positive charge, this is partial negative charge. So here two hydrogen bond formed in the water molecule. Then this is hydrogen. Then we can write this R C double bond O O H. This is partial negative charge. Negative positive here hydrogen bond formed. Then if you take here R C double bond O O H. This is partial negative, negative positive, this form hydrogen bond. So it form more number of intermolecular, inter in between, intra mean within. So this is one molecule, this is one molecule. In between this is one hydrogen bond. Like this, how many are there? 4 hydrogen bond it can form. More number of hydrogen bond formation is there, then solubility also increase. Number of hydrogen bond increase, solubility also increase. Therefore, up to 4 carbons are soluble in water. Then when carbon number increase, solubility decrease. Reason, this hydrophobic part, alkyl group part increase, hydrophobic part nature increase, then solubility decrease. Therefore, this is the reason why this carboxylic acid is soluble in the water. 2 and another carbon number increase, solubility decrease. This is only the its clear explanation about the solubility. So already 3 properties, this is one physical state, one is boiling point, another one is solubility. These are the physical properties. Physical property means what is that? Which we see with our eyes. What is the change? Add acid to the water, soluble or not, it is appear. That is called physical property. Take the carboxylic acid, is it liquid or gas or solid, we can see that with our naked eye. That is physical. Chemical property we can't see. When you add into the beaker, for example carboxylic acid, some compound added, what is change occur, we don't know. But we can see what is the physical state. First liquid is there, later sometime it may be solid or may be gas form. Change we can observe, but how it is occur we don't know. That is chemical properties. Now we discuss about the chemical properties. In that chemical property, first we know carboxylic acid. This is so where the reaction occur in this carboxylic acid. This is the first type reaction. It means OH bond breaking. So I want to say this is derived to the first. It means what are the possibilities? This is one possibility. Another is CO bond breaking. Second type. Third type is total COOH. Third type. Fourth type is reaction on this alkyl group. Then fourth type. Already in alkyl chapter also we discussed, I think this is like this. ROH. OH bond breaking, CO bond breaking, and this alkyl group respective reaction also studied in ether chapter also. Because why I am giving this number 1, 2, 3, 4 meaning? How to remember for examination purpose? Chemical properties are how many are there? Only 4. Then by looking the reaction where the bond breaking is takes place, then we can write easily the product. So in this way you can easily remember. Okay. So now we will discuss the first type. What is the first type? The first type reaction is OH bond breaking. OH bond breaking. How the OH bond breaking takes place? This is RC double bond O, OH. When it is react with the sodium metal. Sodium metal is highly reactive. Otherwise, you know in the first year, first A group elements are, or second A group elements are highly reactive. Similarly, in P block, 17th group and 16th group elements are highly reactive. For their getting stability. If it lost one electron, it gets the octet and it loses the one electron. Therefore, it is react with this acid and liberate the hydrogen. So RC double bond OO minus and here Na plus. It lost one H plus. Na plus means what is that? One electron loss. When it is bond break like this, this is negative, this is what is it? Positive. This positive get the one electron from here, then it converted which one? H. And it is converted into half H2. Half H2 means what is that? Total how many hydrogens are there? 2. Into half how much? 1. So how much hydrogen eliminated here? 1. If you want this is 1 mole here, then what will you do? This reaction you can multiply with the 2. But don't multiply at 2. Because here how many hydrogens are there? 2 hydrogens are there, then 2 hydrogens. Okay? According to textbook, this is like this multiplied with the 2. Some books are keeping it without 2 mean that you will get here half H2. So here which bond breaking here? OH bond breaking. Okay? Next, one more reaction, same OH bond breaking. RC double bond OOH. React with the NaOH. This is acid, this is base. Acid base reactions are very fast reaction. You learn in the first year, acid base reactions are very fast. You don't know now, you just know down the way. Acid base reactions are very fast reactions. Okay? So now this is carboxylic acid. I will write just acid. This is base. Acid and base combine to form which one? Salt. Then we will get here RC double bond O, O minus Na plus here H and here what is it? Then what will form? Water molecule eliminated. Clear? Then it is easy, there is no difficulty. Next. But here, competitive exam purpose, they will ask one more question here from first chapter in the first year, basic concepts of chemistry, they can utilize it. This is acid. Its molecular mass they may give you. For example, take your CH3. CH3 means that it is acetic acid. Acetic acid molar mass from 60. When 60 grams gives is one mole, then here it will be 120. Gives how many moles of hydrogen gas? Otherwise, they may convert it to this is 60. If it is acetic acid, 60 grams gives 22.4 liter of hydrogen gas, because 1 mole of gas means how much it occupies? 22.4 liter STP condition. So they may convert into volume, 22.4 liter. If it is 120, then how much volume will be liberated? In the volume they may convert, in the moles they may convert, or in the form of mass they may convert. 60 grams gives 2 grams, then 120 grams gives how many grams of hydrogen gas? Okay, whatever they may convert in this conversion factor, you know in the first year. Because we feel that first year concept, what is that related, in that chapter only we'll ask in our college examination. But overall exam, when you write the NEET exam or JEE Mains exam that time, this is overall syllabus, first year to second year, they will connect. Because in JEE Mains, how many questions now? 25 questions only. 25 questions mean how many chapters are there? First year 30, second year nearly 14 years. So 13, 14, more than the 30 chapter, 30 questions will not interlinking will come. You have to consider that. Next, RC double bond OOH react with the, consider NaHCO3. This is one of the identification tests for carboxylic acid. It is very, very important for practicals. Theory purpose also important, practically you will do this in your second year. So it is important reaction. Okay? If you observe in your textbook, this bond is given red color or pink color in your textbook. It is normalized black only here. Why they given, no one understand. Because when you are reading normally, equation given, equation we are practicing here. But something important is there here. Now, observe here, this is also somewhat weak base. This is any, this is come from which one? Carbonic acid. You may study in the salt hydrolysis. When you do salt hydrolysis, then somewhat the acidic, somewhat the basic, somewhat the neutral also you may study. If not, you just recall that. Okay? This is weak basic character. Because in this acid also is the base also. How to identify? This is salt formed from NaOH plus H2CO3. This weak acid, this is strong base. So which is dominating character here? Strong. So it is having somewhat basic character. Like you studied in the first year. So it is somewhat basic, because here also base is there. Base and acid react from salt. Here also it forms the salt. Then RC double bond OONA. This is okay. NA bond with this RCO. Remaining water, that is as a byproduct. Here H is there, here H is there. One oxygen take here. Then it forms which one? H2O. And here what is there? CO2. Okay? Now, competitive exam purpose question, what is that? This CO2 comes from this NaHCO3 or from this? That is the question. That point.
Yes.
CO2 gas liberated from sodium bicarbonate or from this carboxylic acid.
Sodium bicarbonate.
Now, here I explain, because you have one answer, they would remain what it is there, CO2, that's why you are telling that answer. But we don't, because this CO may be gone here and this CO may be come out. That is also is there. We don't know mechanism. That's why in textbook they clearly mention with these colors, CO2 eliminated from the which one? This one only, not from the this carboxylic acid. So that much stress we have to do in when you are reading the textbook. Same, from the textbook only this is a question. But competitive exam, it is a very difficult question. Some lectures also don't know from it is coming from this or this. So now, therefore, they will mention here, carbon isotopes, what is there? Carbon 12, carbon 13, carbon 14. For your understanding purpose, I will mean this is carbon 14. Then, carbon 14 here or here. So now we understood that this is from sodium bicarbonate, it is eliminated, CO2 should be like this. this is also one of the identification tests for carboxylic acid. You know that all cool rings have a mixture of carbon dioxide. Under pressure, that is soluble. Gas is being studied in the solution chapter, Henry's law. Pressure increases, solubility increases. So this gas is soluble under pressure. When you just open the cap, then pressure what happened? Decreases. When pressure decreases, the CO2 gas is coming out. And you are doing the practical also for CO2 identification test, confirmation test in the salt analysis. Then this effervescence will come out. That indicator is the CO2 gas. Okay, so you will do this in the second year also for identification of the functional group. This functional group is there or not, how to identify? Add any CO3, then you will get the brisk effervescence of this CO3 gas. Colorless gas will evolve. So this is one of the identification tests. So I am giving the homework for you. Now RC double bond OOH react with the ammonia. Then what will form? This is a question for you. Otherwise, we can take this one also. NaNH2. These are the ones. This we will discuss in the next preparation properties. This will not come. This is homework considered. React with this, what will form. This will come in the next reaction somewhere when CO bond breaking. Okay. So now, this indicating what is there? It has one. OH bond breaking reaction, this is hydrogen gas anything. Next one is also indicating here this reaction, whatever the OH bond breaking, it indicating that this is acid. Where is acid mean? Acid react with the basic form which one? Salt. So this is also indicating that OH bond breaking reaction, that is one of the acid test reactions. When you add base to the any one group, because this is acid or base, we don't know. For example, this is when in this test tube we have this group, then we don't know it is acid or base. When you add base, we know base, we are adding immediately, like a salt formed, mean based on that we consider that this is the acid. Okay, so like acid is some test, what do you call it? Acidic nature, we'll discuss now. Acidic nature. Acidic nature of carboxylic acid. So this is indicating acidic nature of carboxylic acid. Then how this acidic nature will be explained now? Carefully observe. RC double bond OOH, this is carboxylic acid. When you, it is according to ionic equilibrium chapter. Okay. Acid dissolved in water. Then it forms a equilibrium, and this is RC double bond O minus. Carefully observe. According to Bronsted Lowry theory, you may learn proton donor is acid, proton acceptor is a base. Now it forms RC O minus, it is donated H plus to this one H2. Then what it converts now? H3O plus. Then which is acid, which is base? Water, which one now, according to this reaction, base or acid? Base, because proton accept. This is which one? Proton donor. Proton donor is acid. So now we consider that this is acid. Okay, this is acid, this is the base. Because we know that water can act both acid also, base also. This is amphoteric in nature. So this is anion form here. This is carboxylate anion. Carboxylate. Okay. Then how to decide that stronger acid or weaker acid? Keep in mind, after loss of this proton, the formed anion should be stable. If it is more stable, then this acid is very strong. If it is less stable, this is weaker acid. Keep in mind, because we will learn some are strong acid, some are weak acid, some are moderate acid, like we learn in the first year. But how to decide in the organic chemistry? Because inorganic chemistry is based on the Ka value, we can decide higher Ka value, stronger acid, lower Ka value is weaker acid. But here, some factors, electronic factors also involved. What are the electronic factors? Inductive effect, resonance effect, and some steric effects, and some another ortho effect also somewhere involved. So many factors we are affecting to decide this acidic nature of carboxylic acid. So once once again I am telling here, when it is more stronger acid, that formed anion should be stable. If it is unstable, again it is back, reverse reaction, see here this symbol. If it is more stable, it will react in which direction? Forward. If it is unstable, again reacts in which direction? Backward. When it is backward, again in this formula, it will not donate the H+. H+ donor is which one? Acid. Again, it is forming in, it do not donate. Immediately forming in, what is that? That formation of anion is very less. Then we can write according to our equilibrium, K. Equilibrium on Kc. We can write K equal Kc is equal to product by reactants. Product concentration by reactant concentration. R, C double bond O, O minus concentration. H3O plus concentration by R, C double bond O, OH concentration and H2O concentration. Its concentration do not change. It is constant. It is also constant. When it is multiplied with this constant, this is denoted as K equilibrium and H2O denoted as which one? K. You studied in the first year, this is not in the second year part. This is. Otherwise, we write side there. Kc, otherwise equilibrium, into H2O concentration. Constant into constant, another constant is denoted. Okay? 1 into 2, 2 only. So 1 also constant, 2 also constant. Separately, it is indicated by K, A indicating acid. Acid dissociation constant, acid dissociated here. CO minus plus H plus X is dissociated. That's what it is called acid dissociation constant. Now, it is represented as R C double bond O O minus concentration, H3O plus concentration, R COO H concentration. Now, if it is breakdown and formed, this is the product. Then H plus ion concentration is nothing but H3O plus nothing but what is it? H plus one. H plus ion concentration increases when Ka value what happened? Increase. According to mathematics, again mathematics apply here. Numerator value increases means this resulting value also increases. If this value is increases, this value what happens? Decreases. So mathematics apply here. Therefore, when it is more dissociated, more H plus form. More H plus form means Ka value increases. Ka value increases means that is stronger. It means indicating forward reaction. You also learned that Ka value increases forward reaction, Ka value decreases backward reaction. So this is also, all chapters are interlinking here. Not only this organic chemistry, physical always support to explain this organic chemistry. So now based on that I will decide here, Ka value increases, then acidic nature what happens? Acidic nature increases. It's reverse order. Ka value decreases, aroma down decreases, aroma up increases. Because somebody may think, what is this? Okay. So decrease, this is acidic nature decreases. Okay. So now, think once again. Some acids are having very large values. If you observe HCl having a 10 power 7. 10 power 7 after 1, how many zeros are there? 7 zeros are there. Some carboxylic acids are having 10 power minus 50. 10 power minus 50 means before this point, how many zeros are there? Nearly 50 zeros are there. So to write that first value, for us it is very difficult. We can write, but we can't always write that many zeros. Therefore, to avoid that, we are using the logarithmic values. So this K is converted into pK, like pH. Okay. So you know that pH, what is it? Minus log of H plus ion concentration. H plus ion, you can write like this also. Or you can write H plus, no problem. Okay. So this is a pH. Now, instead of this P, it is K, is K minus log K. Here H plus and here H. Here K, here PK. Okay? So now it is PKA is equal to plus, if you convert, then log 1 by K. These are inversely proportional or directly proportional? Inversely proportional. Inversely proportional means now already told you that KA value Now pK value increase means acidic nature decrease. Okay. So now KA increases, pKa decreases, acidic nature increases. It's reverse you can write. Don't waste the time. It's reverse you can write. So now in examination they make always, if you observe the textbook, KA values are very less used in the organic chemistry. Used but very very less. Frequently use this one pK value because organic acids are weak acids compared with the inorganic acids. So that is also one of the important statement here. Inorganic acid which one? H2SO4, HNO3, HClO4, HCl, HBr, like so these are the inorganic acids. All organic acids are weaker compared with the inorganic acids. This is very clear. So these are weaker acids mean their KA value is lower or higher? Lower. But inorganic acid KA value? Higher. So for lower value mean they will get the inversion. 10 power minus. So that 10 power minus we can convert into in this pKa value. It gets a smaller value like 15, 20 like this will get. Okay? In the number. So therefore this pKa is converted from Ka to pKa. That is very important. Now I will give here some questions with respect to this. First I will give one more some hint. pKa less than 1. Less than 1 is right. But pKa is less than, that is very strong acids. Strong acid. pKa 1 to 5, that is moderate acid. Okay. Next, pKa 5 to 10, that is weak acid. Next, pKa here, what do you call? 10 to above all, they are very weaker acid. Okay, then this is not required for to decide the acidic nature, but sometimes it's useful, maybe mains and advanced level, but CET, need level, not frequently asking this range, but sometimes directly they ask in this range, strong, moderate, weak, or very weak, like they will ask. But I want to tell here, keep in mind, lower the pKa value that is strong. That you have to do. Because now I am giving here A, B, C, D. These are the organic carboxylic acids. So it having the tell your any interested number 1, 2, 3, number below 10. What is the number? 7. Here? 6. 3. 4. Now these are having the, these are the pKa values. Now options are given. Question is A, B, C, D are the carboxylic acid with the pKa values are given. So which is the stronger acid? Option A, A. Option B, B. Option C, C. Option D, D. Now which is the stronger acid?
C.
C. Because we know that lower the pKa value, that is stronger acid. So like this question they may give. Now 1, 2, 3 number I give. Sometimes they may give the point values. You have to decide that. Sometimes they may give 10 power minus, 10 power plus something value. You know that mathematics. Okay? Based on that, you decide that which is strong. Sometimes they may convert, which is base, which is more basic. Because what the student will think? This carboxylic acid. That's your intense which one? Acidic means. But they will ask reverse. What they will ask reverse? Which is more basic. Less acidic mean more basic only. So which is more basic? Higher the value. Then here 7 is higher value, A is more basic. So you convert it to the whatever the question they give. Okay? So this is about the acidic nature. Now we will take the example. And already I told you that here the anion should be more stable than only that is more acidic nature. Now I will write here RC double bond OO minus. It will undergo resonance. Then how it undergo resonance? Like